So given the second quarter GDP failing to meet already tempered expectations, will you now be revising your full year estimate already? Originally, you're pegging for 6.1% full year growth. You know, to hit even just the low end of government's 6% growth target, Q3 and Q4 will have to grow at least 6.4% each. Are you confident?
So at the moment, we do recognize the slowdown that has happened in the first half of 2019. However, a part of the reason for the slowdown in growth is being driven by this delay in passing the 2019 budget, and we are expecting some pickup in GDP growth in Q3 and Q4. Already, our growth forecast is at the lower end of the government's target of between 6 to 7%. So for the moment, yes, we are expecting some recovery in growth in the rest of 2019, and we are not looking at a revision, further downward revision of the GDP forecast. However, these are forecasts that we continuously evaluate and monitor. So going forward, if we look at some data which is coming out that points to slightly weaker growth, we could consider a further downward revision. However, at the moment, we're still sticking to our current estimate for the whole year.
Mm-hmm. Sagarika, you currently have the Philippines at triple B with a stable outlook that is, of course, one notch above the minimum investment grade. Do you think you'll be keeping that as well?
So as we've mentioned in our press release, you know, what could trigger a change in the rating? We don't see any of those triggers have been hit. I just want to reiterate that if for any further negative rating action, some of the factors that could lead to that is if we find a reversal of reforms or a departure from the existing policy framework, which leads to macro instability. That could be a trigger for a negative rating action, which we don't think has occurred. Or if there's a further deterioration in external balances, which reduces the resilience of the economy to shock. And if there's an instability in the financial system, which is triggered by, say, a sustained period of high credit growth. So looking at these triggers, at the moment, none of those have been hit. So we are currently at triple B with a stable outlook for the Philippines.
Sagarika, there's a growing concern that our government keeps on borrowing, but spending isn't catching up. And there are so many people asking why the disconnect between the borrowings and the underspending that we continue to see.
So more recently, we think that the slowdown that we've seen in government spending, the overall numbers, some of it shows up in the capital formation data, which has been weak, is partly due to the delay in passing the 2019 budget. But over time, if we look at the data for the central government expenditure, over time, the ratio has been going up for Philippines. Also, that is in line with the fact that the deficit has been widening. When we do our general government to GDP forecast for the Philippines, in fact, for 2019-20, we are expecting the debt-to-GDP ratio to stabilize at somewhere close to 36%. And in fact, in the more recent numbers from 2017 to 2018, in fact, government debt-to-GDP has fallen slightly. So in terms of our view of the overall trend in general government expenditures and the debt numbers, we are seeing a gradual pickup, and we're seeing debt stabilizing at somewhere around 36% going into for this year and next year.
Mm-hmm. Sagarika, speaking of the central bank, we look at the central bank's role. I mean, how pro-growth do you expect the Philippine central bank to be? They did cut interest rates yesterday by 25 basis points. How many more to go for the rest of the year, do you think? And what are the risks that the central bank could overdo those cuts and cause other concerns?
So, yeah, for the moment, we think that the central bank, given its mandate for inflation targeting, I think for this year, the moves are broadly in line with their mandate. Of course, from last year's slightly delayed hike in interest rates, which we were flagging, we've already flagged. I think the central bank has moved now to lower interest rates, which is in line with their broad mandate. So while looking, we're constantly monitoring what the central bank will do going forward, but just looking at the recent weakness in the GDP data and the fact that inflation rates have fallen, we don't think that the central bank's policy at the moment has become pro-growth, but we will continuously keep looking at the steps that the central bank takes. But for the moment, we think that the moves that the central bank has taken are broadly in line with their mandate and are sort of justified looking at the weakness in the GDP numbers and where inflation is at in the Philippines for the moment.
Mm-hmm. So are you expecting the central bank to dial back all of last year's 175 basis point increase?
We don't think whether the entire policy hikes of last year will be wound back or not. We think that the central bank will take its steps looking at how the data and inflation numbers develop in the Philippines. But in general, we think that their mandate remains focused on inflation, as they have stated. And what they have done so far for 2019 seems to be in line with that.
Mm-hmm. And final question, Sagrika, the peso has been quite exuberant lately, even retesting 49 to the dollar. Now we're back to 52 level. Where do you see the currency headed, given all the existing challenges?
So I think the currency is our general view of the peso, given our expectations of Philippines having a current account deficit for this year, next year, given the government's push for infrastructure, is a gradual weakening of the exchange rate. However, interim factors globally could lead to some kind of volatility in the numbers, and it could lead to sudden swings in the currency. But our overall more near-term view for this year, next year, is for the peso to remain on a gradual depreciation path, given the fact that we expect the Philippines to continue to have a current account deficit.
Okay, on that note, thank you very much, Sagrika, for joining us this morning. Great to have you on the show. To watch more ANC videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the bell button for more updates.